We have known for quite a while now that Intel's upcoming Raptor Lake and AMD's next gen Zen 4 CPUs will launch in 2022. Both AMD and Intel confirmed a launch in the second half of the year, but we didn't know when exactly. Second half can be as early as July or as late as December. But we've got some new leaks about the release timeframes, and I have to say, the CPU competition is heating up quite a bit. If these rumors turn out to be true, we might get back-to-back launches from Intel and AMD. Something we haven't seen since 2017, when AMD released the original Zen against Intel's Kaby Lake. Let's take a look at the current rumors around Raptor Lake and Zen 4, when they will launch, and how Intel is turning up the heat. Oh, and by the way, if you wondered about the thumbnail, the raptor in Raptor Lake is describing a bird of prey and not the dinosaur. I know a Jurassic Park raptor would have looked much cooler, but here we are. The last time both Intel and AMD launched new CPUs in the same quarter was back in Q1 of 2017. Intel launched their 7th Gen Kaby Lake CPUs early January, and AMD released the original Zen Ryzen CPUs only 2 months later in early March. From that point on, the Intel and AMD's release cycle never really matched up. It often took half a year or more for the competitor to release their new product. But this year looks like we will see a true competitive release again, because both Intel's Raptor Lake and AMD's Zen 4 could launch in the third quarter. It all started with a tweak from leaker Craymon55, indicating that Zen 4 would not launch in the fourth quarter of 2022. But it wasn't a hint at a possible delay. It was an indication at an earlier launch in the third quarter, maybe even at the start of Q3. AIM5 motherboards are apparently already close to sampling, and Zen 4 could follow soon. An official announcement at Computex in late May with a launch sometimes in July is a very real possibility at this point. This is especially interesting because Zen 3D hasn't even launched yet, and we could see a Zen 4 release in a little over 4 months. And while AMD has indicated that pricing and availability of DDR5 memory might impact the launch of AIM5 and Zen 4, AMD also has to keep an eye on their competition. Last October, Alder Lake took back the performance crown from Zen 3, and with good availability and cheaper B660 mainboards, Intel does offer better price performance at the moment, in addition to a more modern platform. And Intel isn't slowing down, at least not in the desktop space. The Alder Lake refresh, codenamed Raptor Lake, is already closing in. Moore's Law instead is talking about a release in September of this year. With Raptor Lake being a refresh, Intel can move quickly. Raptor Lake is using the same socket, the same architecture with slight IPC improvements and an increase in little core count from 8 to 16, but still manufactured on the same Intel 7 process node. Almost a year ago, video cards leaked a roadmap from Intel advertising Raptor Lake with an improved CPU cache for gaming. We all know how much more performance Zen 3 gained from switching to a full 32 MB L3 cache, and Zen 3D is supposed to gain another 15% in gaming through the addition of extra 3D V-cache. Alder Lake already pulled ahead in gaming. If Raptor Lake introduces a larger cache optimized for gaming and combines it with some general IPC improvements and higher clock speeds, Intel might actually have a true Zen 4 counter on their hands. If Intel is able to release Raptor Lake ahead of Zen 4 and offers competitive performance, it would be a huge blow to AMD, because right now most people are expecting Zen 4 to take back the performance crown. Intel knows they can't let AMD run away again like they did with Zen 3. That's why Raptor Lake's release timeline is so aggressive. Intel is trying to attack Zen 4 with Raptor Lake not only by offering competitive performance, but also by taking the spotlight and trying to launch before or close to Zen 4. AMD is forced to react, even though AIM5 comes with a handicap. Zen 4 only supports DDR5 memory, while Alder Lake and Raptor Lake also offer DDR4 support. It would be in AMD's best interest to launch at a time where DDR5 is readily available and the price has come down to a normal level. If Zen 4 launches while DDR5 is still mostly out of stock and 32 GB go for $300 and up, it would definitely hurt their sales. Intel knows they can pressure AMD with an early Raptor Lake release. AMD has to react, but at the same time, a successful Zen 4 launch is dependent on DDR5 availability and pricing. If Intel can force AMD to launch their Ryzen 7000 CPUs at a bad time, Raptor Lake has a better chance. And if the leaks from Craymon55 are true, AMD has already made the decision to try to release Zen 4 before Raptor Lake. The question is, if this decision was a reaction to the early Raptor Lake launch, or if AMD sees the DDR5 situation improving in the near future. Of course, Zen 4 also has the potential to offer huge IPC gains. It could simply outperform Raptor Lake just like Zen 3 ran all over Rocket Lake. No matter how it turns out, 2022 is tuning up their heat, and it's great to see Intel and AMD going at it again, like back in the good old days. I want to know your opinion. Will Raptor Lake keep the performance crown for Intel, or does Zen Fortress steamroll all over it? Leave a comment down below and tell me what you think. As always, if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and see you in the next video.